So the moment that I begin the camera. Okay, I want to talk, to share a little bit about robotics in Latin America. This is something that is going on. More or less what I want to do is to tell a little bit who I am, why another board, because there is plenty of hardware doing more or less the same. What we have, what we need, and what we expect to come in next. So I have this robot here that some of you have seen working before we start the presentation, but I guess not everybody has the opportunity to see it working. So I'm going to look for this is kind of the first example of when somebody uses robotics to make a robot aware of the environment, and it bounces back and forward looking for a place. So we did that in my office in Nicaragua, and we are here in Rochester seeing one moving along the carpet. So that's the robot that we built. We have something working that's beautiful. I don't know if you can push the button in top to power off, or if you want it to wander freely. Okay, so we can get back to the presentation. Well, my Fedora user is I'm called. I am an amateur radio. Would give me some background. The electronics, it's not the same to be an amateur radio in the US than being in Nicaragua, because in Nicaragua are less strict. They are more worried about the procedures, that you know how not to interfere and not to build things and create things. So it's a different approach. But I can follow instruction. I don't know anything about electronic, but I can follow instruction and solder every single piece of that hardware. As a Fedora contributor, I have been working as an ambassador. For some time, I wrote the weekly bits. I have been involved in marketing, in Tansco. I even get to be in the board before it switched to the council. I have software experience implementing things. Back then I started with the website of my business. I have been implementing software for the company, in accounting and everything, tracking things for maintenance, and I was just getting things useful from the Fedora world and put it toward my business. And I also have experience teaching in higher education, and I get even to launch a higher degree in tourism. That is my specialty as a career. So that is a kind of crazy mix that really fit with the idea of having a robotic that is faced with the challenge of education. So we are not really thinking in a robot by the sake of the robot. We are thinking about the education value that the robot can provide. It's just an excuse for teaching. So we have both worlds, the software and the hardware. And I'm going to show a little bit of the software later. But the idea is that you have something that is easy to be approached by students. One of the things that we are looking is to avoid using the surface mount technology. This is really small components that are really a problem to fix it. This is a very big a very big board, and I can give you a quick glance of the board that I have in the table that is using regular components, regular size. So if something broke, I can diagnose and repair that. And that's a bonus, because what has happened in Nicaragua is that there are some people that bring a lot of Arduinos and give a workshop in a university, and those Arduinos are stored in a closet because the university is afraid that somebody will broke them. But they are not in use, so there is no value in having them available because nobody is using them. So we are trying to move away that using regular components. And another bonus is that the project is wrote in Spanish. So this is thinking about Latin America, that we are going to face a lot of person that doesn't understand English, not even technical English. So we have from the bottom, from the top to bottom, everything in Spanish. And I am here because this is 100% Fedora, the diagram, the simulation diagram, and then the board was designed using Fedora, and all the software is built in Fedora. This is mostly Python and some other libraries, and they're really in the repo, so you can install the software with just a DNF install Icaro, so you can go away with that. But I was saying that robots are here as an excuse. We have a physical world to challenge the student to say, well, if you do this and that, you do the math, and this will be results, and that is abstract. So you can make a robot move an arm, and you make a rule of three to say how many degrees this arm will be moved by this value. And then you can put a ruler to measure that and verify the result, the outcome. And that is, I don't know, that's the way that you make meaningful experience for the kids. And I get this comment from a Spanish teacher that was watching me standing there with the robot in the hand and asked me about that. And I make a small demonstration, and I was waiting for the doors to open for an event. And after I finished, she said, this is something that my students would love to write about. This is something engaging. So it's not that. Something is sterile that the people might or might not be engaged. This is something that really attracts attention. But there is also a value for those schools that bring everybody together from different grades to engage in a project and use teams to solve the problems. And that's a very meaningful way to teach. And I think because this needs a lot of construction and thinking and testing, it is very good for that kind of a scenario. Not all schools use that, but for those, this is something really wonderful. So if you have any question, I'm running too fast, just ask me. What we have is that board that we are seeing is the seventh generation. So we start with a serial communication, and we then ended up that the serial adapter was more expensive than the board itself. So it moved to the next generation to have USB connection. And from there, now we are really facing the problem to have the motors working properly, because sometimes the motor makes a spike and reset the microcontroller, and that makes the robot not really working. It's kind of stuck, going back and forward a little bit. So This is an old fork from Arduino, and that has followed the idea that at the moment Arduino didn't have the USB connection. So somebody figured it out that this microcontroller might fit the bill for that communication because it has integrated the communication for USB. But then Arduino took the step, and this project was set aside. That was Pinguino. That is the word in Spanish for penguin. It was a project from Spain, actually. So this person from Argentina, Valentin Basel, took the idea again and started working in this board. So this is compatible with Arduino. So we can take advantage of the Arduino shells and connect to this robot and make use of them if we want it. Or we can make our hardware connection. It depends on what we have available at hand. The idea of the software is a block programming interface like Scratch or Turtle. It provides the option to write directly C code, because what it actually does is that make us Python pseudo code that is translated to C, and from there is translated to assembler to be put into the microcontroller. That's the idea. It seems kind of twisted, but it works, and it simplifies a lot of things. But it has the option to work in a different set, like this framework, PILAS, that was designed in South America. So this can provide for that pseudo Python code that is aiming to program games to make the game interact with their physical world. And one of the experience was to build with a volume control, a controller for an asteroid game. So you rotate the button and the spaceship was rotating. But also you can actually work with Python. So let's see a little bit of the... I am using currently the developer version. It's nicer. So here we are. We have this thing about just making a small. We have a little problem here with the small screen. Every size, so we can see the basic stuff for the controlling, but then we can go to motors, servos, sensors. So I can put a sensor in here. This is an analog sensor, and the thing is I can compile this, and I can see the source code. I can just jump in and delete something and write something there. The idea is that I can load this into the board that I have here as a kind of an experimentation to see that it's working. Yeah. to move a little bit here, please. Because we have too much light from the red LED. So if I move this volume control, I'm going to have to see the light, the LED bar showing the value in a binary code representing the resistance. It will be a value between 0 and 1024. So I can be the same if I decide just to take this. Sensor. Okay, so we go back to the board to see. Now I have a small push button here that it will turn on the LED. And I push the button. So these are quite simple examples, but it's the idea that I can interact with the board, and it's kind of easy to move the objects and put it into a segments, and that load that into microcontroller to make a robot really working. We can open what is at this moment in the robot that we saw. And then we have a very complex flow of instructions. But really, we can use this library here. This Tortucaro library is meant. So I have the response connecting via the USB cable from the microcontroller. So now I can ask something like, what is going on in the analog sensor? And it will respond that I have a value of 63. If I move a little bit the volume control and I ask the same, will show something different. This is really not fun to see a terminal, serial port terminal communication, but it is useful to the board. Once that we have this connection working, we don't really need to verify it. We can run directly a Python script, because there is a Python library that integrates the object of the robots into the library, for example, to call a servo or to call a motor or to call an analog sensor or a digital sensor, and then we use that in a script for working. So we can think that this is too much for a student in elementary school, but is the way to showing that this can be keep growing with people that start with the blog interface and then move to some Python. And as I say, there is some people that is building something in Ruby to control the board. I don't know why they choose Ruby, but they're doing that in Panama. And I am excited that there are people that took this seriously to build upon that. So what we have is a mailing list that has enough people, so the creator, the crazy person that is behind all this, has to answer every single email. There are some people that knows about electronics that can give you some advice about electronics. There are some people that can give you advice about other topics. There are people that even can you give you advice about education. So we have a very broad background in the mailing list. There is the public repository for the developed version. As I said, it's available in the Fedora's repo, so you can just install directly. And I don't know if this is good or bad, but we have several web pages that are starting to show information about this. There is this technical school in Argentina that has a very tight step-by-step building of the board, which are the components that you are going to use and in which sequence you are going to solder them. So it is easy for you to follow the process and not put something bigger that then would be difficult to solder something small later. So we have different things going on. There is a community from Argentina, Panama, as I say, and Venezuela that is helping with packaging. And Nicaragua has some people doing some coding. I am looking about the needs to put everything together. There is many enthusiastic people. I think robots are really engaging. But not everything is complete or we need something else, because when we need something very simple like a light sensor, you need to put a resistance and you put to connect that to an analog connection. So you need a small explanation for that, and we don't have that. We are lacking of these small examples, these small building pieces to get to make something big. There are many successful robots, but there is no how to make a robot. And I am guilty because I didn't make step by step of these robots because I was so challenged to the building process that I forgot to be documenting about that. But probably because the people that were helping me took a lot of photos, probably we can go back and write something about this. But we also will reflect the fact that in some countries in Latin America, you cannot really find all the stuff that you need, and you have to be a little bit creative with the way, like those wheels are not really wheels, are just a small container that I rebuild, repurpose as many parts of that. And the very beginnings of the robot that we made in Nicaragua were reusing this plastic. But this plastic in specific, because it's bigger, I went to a shop to buy the piece, the whole piece, to have enough to be cutting and creating more thin. So we really need documentation. I have the idea how this has to be taught, if it's going to be put into school, but there is nothing writing down, there is nothing I agree upon that. So we have that challenge, and at least we are in an agreement that this is the next step, that we need to go to get documentation. So one of the nice things is that FoodCon Cordoba 2015 is the next month, and many people will be there that is involved with Icaro. So we will be hanging together and we can discuss a lot of things that it takes ages by IRC or emails or even some quick and back answers using WhatsApp, Telegram, whatever. Take a lot of time, but if we get together, I think that we are going to that we can really put together all the information and start writing documentation. And most important, to build the framework, what we want to achieve with the documentation, so we can fill that framework. The other part is, what I'm doing in Nicaragua with this is that there is no formal approach to robots. There is useful course project for students in the university that they have to do something with microcontrollers or something with software, and they end up doing something with an Arduino board. But after the project, that is not archived in the university. There is no record in the university of the project, so the students of the next year are not challenged to be over that, to improve the last year project. And they don't even have the information that the other people have to did to build those projects. So there is that void. And the government has kind of not knowing who asks about robotics, because they are kind of going to different conferences in Central America and in other countries. There are some activities with robotics. So they are looking at Icaro as a promising idea, because it has a structure for the education that other projects are not showing. So this is kind of our winning bet, because we are kind of having funds for really set to write documentation for education. That is the main purpose of the project at the beginning. So we have a website that is roboticicaro.org. We are putting a lot of information there. There are other information that is not really there, that we need to make links or bring that. But in any case, we are growing something, and I'm really excited to share about this. I don't know if there is any questions or comments.
The block programming interface that you showed,
yeah.
Was that something that was developed for the project, or is that a
yes.
Separate
device? It's specifically designed for the board,
okay.
This Icaro board. So it's a merge. It's not just the hardware, it's not just the software, it's the combo that makes the things work. So, and it's designed, it's programmed using Fedora. So everything is related to Fedora. And yes, it's specific with the board. And one of the things is that it's dynamic. It loads all the small pieces that are in the directory. So if somebody wants to write a plugin, can just write the plugin and put it there. And when start the interface, the software, it will load that. So it can be tested. And if it's working, it can be sent to the repository in GitHub. So more people can test that, and then it can be moved to the stable version. So it's a low barrier for programmers. For instance, there is this ultrasonic sensor for measuring distance that is made for Arduino. A year ago, there was no plugin for that. There was not a component in the sensor list for that. Now there is a section that says special sensors, and Under that, that is the ultrasonic sensor, so you can just load that as a block and just connect that into the analog section of the board for receiving the information. What else about the software? It's mainly written in Python. More questions? Okay, so thanks for your attention, and I hope that you keep tab on this project to see how we are doing in the near future. Thanks.
This is the funny time that my face is really big in the screen.